You know, for me, the importance of having a Veterans Day assembly is it's so important that we let our veterans and our active duty know how much we appreciate them. There's so much that they are sacrificing as we are sleeping each night under a blanket of freedom. The things that, you know, we have the luxury of doing here, they are missing out on.
So this assembly to my family is pretty important just because my dad is in the Army. He was just recently deployed. He deployed January 10th and got back November 2nd. It was actually a surprise to me. He was actually supposed to get back the November 8th. Ended up coming home 6 days early.
Hey, can we ask you guys a question?
Sure.
How did you guys do in districts?
Well, it was really cold, and I ran a few minutes behind pace, but it was still really fun.
I PR'd and had a lot of fun.
I also ran a couple minutes behind pace, but it was a good time.
So for the district championship we played Stratford, the girls did really well. We ended up losing, but they played their heart out.
Yeah, I thought at the end we finally came together and everybody was doing their job on the court and doing what they were supposed to do, and we all played really well.
Hey, you mind if I ask you guys a question real quick? How did soccer districts go this year?
I think we did pretty good, considering like no one ever expected us to make it to the championship, but we did.
Yeah, and I mean, definitely picked up some skill before, because let's be honest, we weren't that great before during the regular season games.
Thank you for coming to today's ceremony of the Thanksgiving.
It looks mint.
So, what's on the menu today? Ah, mashed potatoes? You know, I think I'm gonna go for that. Looks pretty good. You know, I could pass that.
You know, I think I'm gonna try some quality stick. Pretty dense in protein, I say.
What else would I want to eat? Geez, you know, actually, screw this. Okay, your food's awful. It tastes like paper. I mean, come on.
Oh man, hey, you forgot your hat.
Aw, thanks, bro.
Hey, it's gonna be all right, man. Hey, let's go get some real food.
You know what? That sounds pretty good. Let's...
Did you hear about those new competitive mini golf?
Oh yeah, like the ones with the really short sticks and just pink.
Yeah, and it's like golf, but miniature.
And competitive.
Yeah, it's crazy, right?
Yeah, it's crazy.
So basically what a competitive mini golf is where you go to like a place like Fun Acre or something, and then you pay money to play, and then you like win big prizes and win stuff. So yeah, it's really fun. Make some money off of it, and it's a blast hanging out with the guys, so. So we have different kind of tournaments. We have an aces only tournament, we have stroke play, and then we have match play. So the aces only is where you just count hole in ones. The stroke play is where you just play three games and then count all your strokes at the end. And then match play is where you go one-on-one against a guy and you try to beat him out. So it's fun. Okay. So basically we started like the beginning of summer and then went all summer, and now it's going into second season. It's like a winter season where it's like indoor. But we had about 16 tournaments. And we're gonna have about 10 in the winter, so yeah, I'm prepared.
what is the current project your students are working on?
So I had somebody come to me and tell me that the green team took a major hit because our plastic recycling disappeared. And so they said, hey, is there any way that you could help? And I pitched that idea to our PBL class. And so our project is about plastic recycling.
So what is a PBL class?
PBL class is a project-based learning class, and so instead of me standing up here and talking at students and then giving them a worksheet and then giving them a test in a traditional pattern, they go through the exact same type of material except for in a project.
What has surprised you so far about how this project is going?
The biggest surprise is probably how difficult this project has been. This project has been obstacle after obstacle after obstacle. Finding people that are willing to give us information, to help us, to partner with us has been a lot more difficult than I anticipated.
So first we're doing research, and that's really the only part we're doing right now. And our research consists of us contacting other schools with a recycling program and asking them questions about how they made it work. Some conflicts we've come across are, we've had our recycling in the past for the whole community, but there was a lot of dumping, and there's definitely going to be a need for a lot of help from the community on preventing that. And we've also run across some schools just, they don't have very many answers for our questions. Some recycling centers can't answer questions because it's classified. We have a very tight budget here, and it's hard to find where we're gonna get.
Why is this kid's homework always trash? Ms. Braddock!
Thank you.
Save the planet.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb.